So you directed me quite a few times. We've actually worked together in the 90s as well. So our careers have been woven together. You
Yes.
remember me from my Rosie Colucci era, which was really the dream. Jay Shanahan went along with it. I wanted to be named Rosie Colucci. I never intended to use my real name, Lisa Ann. He went along with it for my whole first movie or two. You knew the name, like certain people know the name. But when you put together that series for Wicked with the lifeguard and I'm in the bathtub, like it blows my mind to this day. Jonathan, that scene is on Reddit all the time. People use it as a GIF. Like this thing is so huge, and it was just such a lighthearted thing. I mean, I remember we were laughing and having a great time when you gave me the idea. This is so much fun. It was a lighthearted thing, but was it something we had to do because we were going to use a pool and it rained, or was there a reason we went inside instead?
Well, the concept of the movie, they wanted to do, and as you know, I'm known for my comedic stylings. So
Right,
I'm
my
always
favorite
doing comedy.
campy. Yes, yes.
So I'm always doing comedy. So they said, hey, we would like you because one of the movies that was coming out was Baywatch. And they said, hey, we want you to do a Baywatch spoof, but with your little flair. And I was going, okay. And they were like, but here's the one thing. You can't use any public beaches. And I'm like, okay,
True.
how am I going to do that?
True.
So thus the, okay, everybody's a lifeguard and wherever I can find water is where we can find it. So what ended up happening on the day that I shot you was we were shooting, I think it was three scenes that day, and two of them were already at the pool. And I couldn't use that pool again. And we're like, well, where are we gonna go? And I think it was like my lighting guy said, hey, there's a pretty big bathtub upstairs. And I go, great, she'll be the lifeguard of the bathtub. And I remember you're just like looking at me going, why am I doing this? And I go, it's gonna be funny, trust me. But you know what? Give it to you. The one thing when that camera rolled, man, you gave 110%. You knew it was gonna be. Slapstick, you knew it was going to be silly, but you played it like a trooper, like you were straight faced. And God, it was classic. I really enjoyed working with you because I always knew that I was going to get a person who was going to give me 110% and trusted me in putting them in situations where on the outside, it would look like you're making me look dumb. But what I was trying to do was make you look funny. And it ended up, becoming that. You look funny.
It was brilliant because I watched it 1,000 times since then. So it's edited on kids' YouTube pages. Like it's not about the sex, okay? It's really about this scene and the dialogue back and forth. And they zoom in on my face and how serious I was looking at him as I'm holding on to the little life preserver, like I'm David Hasselhoff. I mean, it was brilliant. It was fun, and I think it's remarkable to be remembered for that. I could ask these same kids about the Sarah Palin series, Who's Nailin' Palin? They'd have no idea. The lifeguard. So I'm America's favorite bathtub lifeguard, as I get that reference a lot.
Well,
So
that is perfect. Let me tell you, out of everyone that we hired on that to in that movie, you look by far look the best in the red Baywatch swimsuit. You absolutely killed it.
well, there were always things that I did. When I got in the business, having tattoos wasn't a thing. And though we have nothing against tattoos, directors and club owners and photographers in the late 80s, early 90s, they did. And they said, working around this, it's not gonna look great. And later, as I viewed everybody, I realized how different it is because you could kind of dress me in anything and I could fall into that neutral spot where it is a bit different if there's a tattoo down the side of the leg or something that just draws the eye away from it. We're supposed to be a palette. And so I remember that the time we only, porn stars only got tattoos on the back of our necks. Remember that? In the mid-90s, we were all doing the back of our, which I did one. I got it removed, okay? Because I was like, how great is this in spin class? I look like a gangbanger because I have this big script tattoo in the back of my neck. But that was a ton of fun.